and thanks for coming to the Home Roots Group. I'm sure you all know, but my name is B. Rutledge, and I'll be your MC. A couple of housekeeping notes before I introduce the band. You'll notice our lights are a little different tonight. We have adjusted the spotlights from your eyes. They will be back to normal at our next concert. Now to get to what we came here for. The South Peace Arts Council is excited to present Casati, a contemporary jazz trio from Winnipeg. You will enjoy their lush harmonies compiled by ukulele, guitar, double bass, and a hurdy-gurdy. They will be performing two sets tonight, and will, with a short intermission for you to stretch your legs, meet the band, buy a CD, lots of CDs. Have a look at the current exhibit featuring Ken Housego from Grand Prairie. Help us welcome Casati to the stage.
Played with people up above us before. So we'll try to look up there every once in a while, but we'll probably forget. We're traveling through from Winnipeg, Manitoba, and this is our first Home Roots tour, and we're having a great time so far, and very happy to be performing here in Dawson Creek. We're going to do two sets of original music for you, and as you will hear, we're very interested in many different genres, and like to incorporate all of our favorite musical styles into the music that we write. So we're going to start off with the title track from our latest album that we released last year. It's called There Will Be Days, and it is about how some days are better than others, but on the dark ones, you have to just keep your head down and keep going, because there's a good one just around the corner.
You're in a hard place with your back against the wall.
finding yourself in a place you don't want to be anymore. And I think this is a fairly common thing people go through. But I do think as human beings, we can become very complacent and we love complaining. So instead of doing anything about it, we will just stay where we are not happy for much longer than might seem reasonable. So this is a song about reaching a point where the idea of staying becomes scarier than facing the complete unknown. This is called Strong Wind. About the end of a relationship, kind of the gray period at the end of a relationship where you aren't together anymore, but you know each other really well, and if something happened and you needed somebody to be there, maybe that would still be the person that you turned to. And this is called Hold On To Me.
next song is called Joe. I work at a care home back in Winnipeg, and wasn't one of the residents there. I play music at this care home, and one of the residents there, his name was Joe, and he would always bug me to play him some Spanish music whenever I'd visit. And I don't play any Spanish music really, but I'd always try and come up with something just to please Joe. So I wrote the song about visiting with him and some of the stories he told, and it's written in a totally inauthentic Spanish style.
Themes.
We're here to lift your spirits. Everything's better than what's happening in our songs. It's about a breakup where you don't understand why the other person doesn't feel the same way that you feel. And in this case, it is about one person wanting to leave, like really leave, not leave the relationship, but like leave the country also. And so if you were in love with someone and they were like, I'm moving away, that would be hard and also very difficult to understand how you could love somebody so much and then not have them feel the same way. So this is a song about that feeling of not understanding. It is called Tell Me.
Rolling your
Especially a strong tradition in France from the 17 and 1800s. But the French name for the instrument makes a little more sense than hurdy-gurdy and how it works. The viol à roue or wheel viol or wheel violin is the idea behind this machine. So rather than the, like on the bass, I was using the bow, which rubs the strings and creates friction and gets the string going. For this instrument, there's the bow is a wheel, and so you get a never-ending sound when a string is engaged. And the first piece we're going to do with this instrument is an instrumental piece that Grace had the idea, heard the idea that that she wanted to base a piece on. When she's in the Paris train station, there's over the intercom, there's a little melody that is played before they make an announcement, and it sounds like. And then you know.
Our song's longer than that.
Our song is longer than that.
But that was the inspiration.
That was the inspiration. That was just the little fragment that Grace gave to me to do something with. That and also the idea of being in an odd time signature, like odd number of beats rather than 4/4 or 6 or something. We decided to do this in 7 beats per bar, mostly. It moves around. But for this piece, when I composed it, I was sort of imagining being on an old train and journeying from car to car and encountering different characters. And the piece is kind of structured like that in little kind of morsels of themes. And a couple of days ago, we were in Hinton, and we played a little set for the school kids, like K-6. And we decided we were going to play this one for them, even though it might have been a bit challenging or something. But we asked them all to close their eyes and just imagine what characters or scenes they might see on their train ride. And they had a lot of fun and a lot of cool ideas. One little girl was talking about this rainbow her train was riding out into outer space and this whole big galactic journey. So maybe that'll happen for you, but who knows?
Thank you.
to pull out another instrument now. She bought this, we were touring last, was this in the fall? Last fall, I believe. And we were touring Western Canada, and we were in Calgary with some time off, so she was checking out Kijiji and found this beautiful auto harp. So we picked that up and started using it immediately, and the song we're going to play for you is actually an older song. We recorded under Grace's name 4 or 5 years ago, and this song was recorded during that period of time, and we hadn't really touched it for a while, and then as soon as we had this instrument and we had introduced the hurdy-gurdy to the group, we decided to pick that one up again. It seemed to have the right carnival sort of vibe that fit these instruments. So this song is called Sparrow.
Somebody, and you know you found something very special, but you don't know if they feel the same way about you. And it could go either way, you know? So this could be a very emotional time, because it's you can feel like you're just standing still waiting for this other person to decide how they feel about you. So it can be an emotional time, but there's something kind of beautiful about finding that no matter which way it goes. So this is called sleepwalking.
Time stop.
set for you. And this next one often gets, it shares a name with a song that already exists, but it's not the one you know. It's called Bicycle Built for Two. And we on our YouTube channel, we don't have any comments at all on our videos, except for one. And it's on this one. And the comment was, "This was not the bicycle built for two that I was expecting." So someone decided that, you know, we should know that. Neither negative or positive, so we're all right with that.
Yeah.
So we'll do this one and have a little break, and then we'll be back with some more music. Thanks for listening.
speakers, and we are from a really Ontario, Canada.
Second set with a song about not letting other people tell you what you should, what will make you feel complete. I think there's this feeling of emptiness that everybody can experience once in a while, and I think it's always there, but once in a while we'll start to feel like we need to find something to fill that that hole inside. And so this is a song about really taking the time to figure out for yourself what will make you feel whole and like you're doing what you're supposed to be doing and not letting other people tell you what that would be. This is called The Void. Inside my heart there is a hole. No, no, no. something from that now. This is the title track off of that album. And I wrote this, well, after I graduated from music school, I felt really drained and done with music for a little while. Because no matter how much you love something, doing it every day for 5 years is a lot. So I felt like I needed to take a break and then reassess what I wanted to do if I wanted to do music as my career. And so I took a year off and felt this real pull to go back and to start writing my own music and to start kind of a new musical journey. Even though the idea of doing that was very scary because there's no guarantees at all in this industry that that anybody will care that you're doing it. So this is a song about facing that fear. It is called Afraid of Heights. Thank you.
wrote this next song, but I'm going to sing it. And the reason I'm singing it is because it is the story of me running out of money and having to pawn my guitar. It is not a true story, but we'll see what happens.
Please be generous. That's the merchandise.
That's what I'm hinting at over here. Thank you, my man. So this song is dedicated to my guitar. This is called Six String Goddess.
Never leave my mind.
gonna do for you. I wrote around the same time that I wrote The Void. So it's also kind of about not letting other people tell you what you should do. I feel pretty passionately about that. It's a great thing to be passionate about. People love getting your advice when your advice is don't listen to what anyone is saying. So I wrote this next song when I was really into Patti Smith, and I felt like she had some really wise words and a lot of wisdom for the time she was living in, and I wanted to write a song about how a lot of those problems hadn't changed at all. And this is called Mother's Pearls. Did I tune? I don't remember.
Thank you.
it was inspired by, when I'm not performing, I also teach singing lessons. And last year I was helping one of my students, a 10-year-old, deal with some stage fright. And I didn't really know exactly how to deal with that, because I didn't want to just tell her to do it. I wanted her to choose to do it. And so I realized I hadn't felt that scared of anything. Like, she was so horrified about doing this performance. And so what I did was I sat down and talked to her about just being afraid and explained that, you know, when I was 10, I was scared of the things she was scared of. But now I'm not 10 and I'm scared of new things, and that there'll always be something to be afraid of, no matter what age you are. So if you don't learn how to face your fears, even if you don't always win, then you'll be stopped a lot of the time from even trying something. So this is a song inspired by her, and realizing that all my fears just changed into something else, but I'm doing my best. So this song is called Monsters. Under the bend there lives a demon in the dark, with eyes as red as rubies and a cold stone beating heart. He sounds just like the wind when he cries out in the night. He lives in the shadows, I hide in the light. He slithers at my feet, I hear him call my name. Tells me not to get too brave. A lot of things can happen to those who rise and fall. He's heard the others talking, they prefer me to stay small. Mount your steeds where
going to do, I wrote the lyrics and the melody for, and I wrote it after my Baba passed away. She was 90, and she later in her life was in living in the home. She had quite bad dementia, but nevertheless, it was quite difficult to lose a loved one. I'd never experienced that previously, and so afterwards, I was feeling pretty down. And around that time, it seemed especially heavy to turn on the news and see what's going on in the world politically and with human rights situations and environmental crises and so on. But then out of that, that kind of cloud of kind of heavy feelings, I heard this melody and these words, and sometimes it's just like that. You just kind of write it down from where you hear it from. And yeah, this one is called Crooked Road, more in a bluegrass kind of style.
Crooked Road, closing doors and closing minds. Why we just cannot be kind? Why do we do what we don't believe? Give someone what they really need, what they
when I was there by myself. I would hear all these voices behind doors and just like weird creaking, like there were people there, but there was nobody else there. And one day I was talking to the janitor about it, and he just said, yeah, this floor is haunted. Just like matter of fact. And I thought, oh, I don't feel better now knowing that for sure. Someone else thinks that there's something weird going on here. So I went back to my desk and I kept a ukulele there for when I needed one. and wrote this song about the office ghost. And then the next day I came in and all of the ceiling tiles around my desk had fallen down. So I just embraced that. That was the ghost saying, cool song. And I named him Rodney and wished him well. So this is for Rodney. It's called Invisible. On our newest album. The first one is about how when we kind of change like we leave a job or we move, it's weird. We feel like we're the thing that's changing, so it always feels like you'd be able to go back and everything should be the same, but this is not the case ever. You really can't go back. Those relationships change pretty quickly. And so this is a song about accepting that, that change, and also that people's actions speak louder than their words. So no matter what somebody might say they're going to do, there's the people who do it, and then the people who just say they're going to do it. So this is a song about that called The Ugly Truth. But before we play that, Quentin's going to take us on a little expedition.
Yes. We all studied jazz together, I think Grace mentioned, and at the University of Manitoba. And part of that experience means you do a lot of improvising, a lot of spontaneous composition, and that kind of in the moment interacting with each other, and ideally playing in a way that everything that each person improvises or spontaneously composes gets accepted and then enriches the musical experience, where I guess the it's sort of like having well, for instance, the train song that we did earlier, I had pre-composed a lot of that, but then I brought it to the trio, and then when you have more brains working on something, you know, more brains, it gets better, and you can, the ideas that came out of us working together were far, they're my favorite parts now of that piece, rather than what I just thought of myself. All that to say, that's sort of the philosophy of how we approach our arranging and our composing and all that, but we do also love to leave room for improvisation. A lot of the solos we were doing tonight were improvised, and so now I'll do some improvisation before we go into The Ugly Truth.
Thank you.
Here's this song to sing the ugly truth. It isn't what you say, but what you do that makes you who you are. Who you are. It isn't what you say, but what you do that makes
for coming out and supporting local music, or not local music, but local organization putting on music, and we hope that you've had a great evening here with us. This last one we're going to play, is a song about making sure that you're living in the moment and that you're always paying attention to where you are and what you're doing. Because in this day and age we live in, it's really easy to get kind of sucked into this virtual reality of our phones and our computers. And the truth is, none of that really matters at the end of the day if you're not paying attention to the places you actually are and the things that are actually happening around you. So this is a song about that. Thank you so much again. And this is called Before You Go. Where did the daylight rush off to? And so Gabby, and we are Casati. Thank you so much for listening.
God could love a child in this condition. God could love a child in this condition. Go tell it on the mountain. Say, go tell it to the judge. Pray for freedom, pray for mercy. Mercy. If I sin, Lord, it was all for love. Thank you. stars drift by an old campfire. Praise the Lord, pass the admonition. God could love a child in this condition. God could love a child in this condition. God could love a child in this condition. God could love a child in this condition.
Thought he was a god, but the cat came back. He just wouldn't stay away. Here tonight at the Chetland Community Arts Council Fall Gala. We've been holding them every, I think this is the sixth year, and we put a call out to artists in the community, gather their art together. What you see here is the reception evening where we plan a bit of a party with desserts and fabulous conversation and taking a look at the art. It will be hung until the end of November. The gallery is open from 11 until 2, Monday to Friday, most Mondays to Fridays. And so you could come in, and see, if you missed tonight, you can come in and see this lovely art for the next 2 weeks.
It goes way back, incorporated in 1980. And I've been with the Arts Council for the last 6 years. I'm part of like the new Chetwynd Arts Council. We revitalized it 6 years ago with our first fall gala. We've been doing one every year since, and you're witnessing the sixth annual fall gala with our revitalized Arts Council.
We are absolutely delighted. Last year we had about 7 people in town who had never publicly shown their art before, and they showed last year. We were just thrilled with that, because the whole point of this is for artists to have a place to display their work and hopefully sell some as well. So these are all local artists. We've got young adults, we've got older people like myself. There's oil painting, acrylics, pen and ink, fabric arts, some sculptury stuff with a buffalo skull, I think, some wood. So it's a whole variety of wonderful stuff that's created by creative people right here in this area. Tonight's turnout is wonderful. Yes, it's just great. I've been so busy talking and chatting with so many different people. We're very pleased with the turnout, absolutely.
Plans. Like, we do a lot of work, which I'm not going to get into kind of right now, but we do so many wonderful projects annually. We continue, our plan is to add to it, grow our portfolio, and really provide arts for every demographic of our community.
We also have other workshops that come in. I myself am a certified Zentangle teacher. So I have a new intro class coming up Thursday night. So call the Arts Council and check our Facebook page, and maybe you want to learn how to draw fabulous abstract art.
Act. They are legends here in this country, and their music has truly stood the test of time. Everybody, put your hands together for Chilliwack!
She didn't have to leave me. She didn't have to run. She didn't have to go without a word to anyone. Hope she's doing all right. I got no way to know unless she gets to hear this song, hear it on the radio.
CHET TV is proud to present a hand-picked selection of some of the finest and most memorable short animated films, courtesy of the Canadian National Film Board, for your viewing pleasure. Airing every Saturday and Sunday morning on CHET TV.